In just the last couple of days, areas of Texas saw two 1,000-year flood events and two 500-year flood events.
First Warning meteorologist Eric Burris explains what those terms actually mean.
Hey there from Chopper 2. We're coming to you from Astor in Volusia County. Take a look. This is a community along the St. Johns River. So often when we see big rain events, hurricanes and the like, this is an area that floods. It's more prone to flooding. It's a fork, a big fork in the St. Johns. It's a stopping point. And unfortunately, I've been up here personally covering many events where so many of these homes have had water in their homes. When we look at flooding events, though, let's talk about Texas, for example. In just the last couple of days, the areas of Texas have seen 2,000-year flood events and two 500-year flood events. But I wanted to make sure to really help you understand what that means. It doesn't mean that this kind of flooding will only happen once in 1,000 years, not at all. That nomenclature, that terminology actually came from looking at percentages. So for example, the 1,000-year flood means that in a given year, you've got a 1 in 1,000 chance of seeing a flooding event like that. And in Texas, they've had events close to this back in the 1980s and certainly even before that. Look here in Central Florida, Hurricane Ian, okay? That was, in some parts of Central Florida, a 500-year flood event. Again, that just means that in a calendar year, you've got a 1 in 500 chance of seeing something like that. Right now, though, it's been stormy, but thankfully we have no flooding events in our area, and the residents here in Astor are enjoying the good life along the St. Johns. Hopefully we can keep it that way with no flooding. Time will tell. That's the very latest covering Volusia County from Chopper 2. I'm meteorologist Eric Burris, WESH 2 News.